Hello, Patrick Walchuk, and welcome to an update in the Ottawa real estate market to the end of July 2022. So if you enjoy getting these things, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and we'll get them sent out to you every 30 days. So let's get right into it. We'll be talking about residential homes, followed by condos, and then we'll provide you with the month-over-month average sale price that you've asked us for in the past. So for residential homes, you can see that in the month of July, they were down significantly by 37%. That's a huge drop. And if you remember from the last video, I think they were down about 30% in June versus June. So a very substantial drop. Prices compared to July of last year are call it 770. That's an increase of about 6.1%. And in terms of the inventory levels, they are up to 2,780 homes for sale, which is a huge increase of 73%. So for you sellers out there, you have more competition. For you buyers out there, you've got a better selection than you had last month and the month before. And in terms of how long it's taking for a house to sell, it's taking about an extra week compared to July of last year, 20 days compared to 14 days. So we'll move on to the condominium, see what's happening in this world. And not a whole lot different compared to, you know, what we were just looking at in terms of Freehold. Sales are down about 36% compared to last year. Prices, now they're not up the same way that we saw Freehold homes are. Well, they're almost flat with last year, coming in at around $426,000. Inventory levels also are up for condos, so you condo sellers, you've got more competition than you did last month. In terms of how long it's taking, they're selling in a few more days on average than they were last year. Now, here's an interesting number. We saw that Freehold homes, for example, where they were up about 6% in terms of price compared to last year. That's compared to last year. This is compared to month over month. So you can see the numbers here, and what's kind of interesting or significant is that when we look at June, prices were down 4.9% compared to the previous month, and in July, they're down about 4.8% compared to last month. So does that mean they're starting to stabilize? But when you look at these numbers and the average prices, they're down about 14% compared to where they started out in February. If you have any questions, give me a call. Patrick.